Quality Function Deployment, QFD. The second phase is the benchmarking. Here, we look for products from the competition. The design team identifies the products of the competition and selects the most significant for analysis. Here, you're looking for the customer perception scores of competitive products. It's important to show the matrix and the graphic route generated from the scores, because it's the second phase of the QFD. The user gives a score based on the previous requirements for the helmet of the competition.
I had this helmet and it's good. For me, it's a 5. For me, this helmet isn't aerodynamic. I think it's a 2. I think that the competitor one looks secure, so for me, it's a 5.
The design team identifies the products of the competition and selects the most significant for analysis. Here, you're looking for the customer perception scores of competitive products. It's important to show the matrix and the graphic route generated from the scores, because it's the second phase of the QFD.
I think that the competitor one looks secure, so for me, it's a 5.
The design team identifies the products of the competition and selects the most significant for analysis. Here, you're looking for the customer perception scores of competitive products. It's important to show the matrix and the graphic route generated from the scores, because it's the second phase of the QFD. The graph on the right side of the matrix allows us to see clearly the customer's opinion about the competitor's product. What can you conclude from the graph? Okay, so far we have already analyzed the user needs, along with their perception about the competitor's offer in the helmets market.